guys, this video is going to tell you about how an electric mountain board works, or at least how I built mine. So first of all, as you can see on the screen, this is actually the side view of my skateboard. I know, my art skills is top notch. Took a lot of time to draw that. So, as you can see here, top line outlines the board, the wooden or bamboo part of the board that provides flex and a platform for you to stand on. The dotted lines on the two sides represent the wheels of the electric mountain board, and the weird chess piece looking like thing in the middle of the wheel is the trucks of the electric mountain board. Now, as you can see that on the left hand side of the board, which is the rear end of the electric mountain board, I'm currently drawing the connections of the motor, the gearing, the belt, and then now I'm drawing the VESC. So that's the variable electronic speed control. So in here, we see that the motor, which is mounted onto the truck through a metal piece. I mean, it's a piece of metal. So it's just shaped so that it can fit onto the truck and at the same time hold on to the motor so that it has the right tension on the gear. So the gear is actually tuned to more torque than speed, as you can see from the tiny gear on the motor and the extremely large gear on the wheel. This way, more turns of the motor is required for one turn of the wheel. By doing this, you increase the torque of the motor of the skateboard, which is measured in Newton meters. So the more torque you have, the easier it is for you to start your skateboard. So with such a setup, you can actually start the skateboard without giving it a kick, or even climb up steeper hills. So this is the benefit that it brings you. And with my motor, I have a very high KV, in which case is the RPM per volt. So with a high KV, it means that for the same amount of voltage supplied to the motor, you will have a lot higher revolutions per minute. This increases the top speed of your motor, in which case increases the top speed of your skateboard. But since I have so much speed, so much extra speed that I have no way of using, I tuned it so that the motor would use up more of the speed to power the skateboard and provide it with more torque instead of providing it with a higher top speed, per se. Now, after that, you see on top the VESC. Now, the VESC sends information to the motor to allow it to spin. And following that, it goes into a UBEC, which powers the receiver. And the receiver is what sends, what collects information from your controller to tell the VESC to either accelerate, decelerate, or control the VESC into whatever set speed you want so that the motor can spin at the right speed. And after all that happens, it's connected to the battery. So the battery, as you might expect, provides power to the entire skateboard, not only powering the motor, but also the internal components of the VESC, the receiver, and all these like electronics on the board so that it can have the power to move you. And the two weird bumps on the board are the feet ties. So that's where you slide your feet in so that you can have a secure stance on this board. Now, I know this might seem a little complicated when you look at it on the skateboard itself, and everything seems to be cramped into the back. So I'm gonna draw a much more simple and easy to understand layout for the entire setup. So starting off, the battery. This is the power source. Now, the battery connects directly to the VESC. So the variable electronic speed control, they're actually there's actually originally the thing was called an electronic speed control, but the electric skateboard community created a variable electronic speed control. The difference between these two is actually really big. So a VESC allows you to fine-tune the adjustments in the ESC, while a normal ESC would just provide you with a set standard. So for example, a VESC, you can adjust a linear acceleration or an exponential acceleration or a linear deceleration or immediate deceleration, and you can adjust the percentage of deceleration throughout the ride. Now you can see on the other side of the VESC is a motor. So now these motors have three phases, which have three coils in them. And you'll see later on that I draw three lines from the VESC to the motor, because there is three wires coming out from the motor. And the VESC's job is basically to send information to the motor so that it knows how fast to spin. And to do that, it sends the motor power from two lines at a time. So now, once that the power from the two lines is sent, it changes to another two line and another two line. So this pushes the rotor inside the motor to different stages. And by controlling the speed at which it changes changes the two lines, it can change the speed at which the rotor is spinning at, which is how the VSC controls the speed. Now, as you can see, the UBEC, which is the UBEC, is basically just a small component that powers your receiver. Sometimes your receiver does not need a device like this to power your receiver. Sometimes it has its own power that can be drawn from the VESC. But in my case, there wasn't, so I had to get an extra UBEC, which you have to make sure that can fit your battery rating. Now, all I did was just splice a line in the battery so that the UBEC could be connected onto the battery terminals. Now, the UBEC is connected to the receiver, and your hand holds the controller. So basically, for the controller, you have a throttle and a brake. Now, this is directly sent to the receiver, so that the receiver can tell the VESC what to do, and the VESC will take energy from the battery to power the motor at the right speed. So this might sound a little complicated, but it's just an overall general network of how this thing works. Now you might be questioning, how do you control the direction of the turn of the motor? See, this is a very simple there's a very simple solution to solve this problem. So if the motor is turning clockwise and you want it to turn counterclockwise, because you don't want one wheel to be spinning backwards while the other is spinning forwards and just create total chaos. So to fix this problem, all you need to do is switch any two lines of the VESC. And this allows for the motor to start spinning in the opposite direction, because as I said before, the VESC just swaps two lines at a time. And if you add two lines of power at a time to change the different stages, but once you flip two of the lines as shown right now, you will be able to change the direction of the motor, because the different phases will be in a different position, in which case would lead to a different direction. So yeah, that's about it. So the next video I will begin the build and show you all the components that you need and how to put an electric mountain board together. If you guys have any questions, please leave a comment. Please like and subscribe to the video. You guys are great. Thank you.